Alrighty, take over a second. There's some stuff I'm fooling around with. And there is something I'm researching. And I'm taking notes on these things so that I can best determine how to deal with a combination of things in Warframe, including Steel Path. I haven't done any research into how to damage. I've just brute forced my way through it, and it's worked up till now. So, I'm sitting here looking things up, writing them down. Me writing them down helps them stay in my mind. And I was also thinking, why not give a predetermined reward for completing a planet in the Steel Path mode? A lot of people want to do hybrid builds for fun, and me personally, I don't know about the rest of you, I want to brute force the living crap hold out of playing the game, as far as putting out damage and killing everything on the map as quickly as possible. I had an idea for extra mods. Say you complete Earth in the Steel Path, you get one of those uncommon or common, the bronze colored mods. I think those are common. Yeah, those are the common ones. It's fucking 1 or 2 a.m. Who is out running down the street? Now this is, this idea I've got is subject to public inquiry, as well as the idea of rewarding the effort put in, gains for effort sort of thing. But anyway, a common mod that increases status and critical by, instead of a percentage of the base value, just increases the base value up to 50%. If not completing Earth, then somewhere on the Steel Path. And since stat and critical no longer have a cap of base 100%, as semi-recent change to status to where it goes over 100%, I think that serves the power fantasy as well as gains for effort, and providing a somewhat acceptable reward for completing planets in the Steel Path mode. The other one I was thinking of is the 60-60 mods, such as things you put on the rifle, thermite rounds, malignant force, rhyme rounds, and high voltage. Yeah, why not give a 90-90 for stat and proc and chance? In addition to that, once you get so far into the Steel Path, give a reward from tension or Something that allows you to, once you get to that certain point, after you complete that certain planet, it opens up a steel path reward with tension that allows you to purchase from him a mod that adds all six of the elemental combinations and all four of the base elementals, as well as the standard impact slash and puncture. Having to look up for the fucking names of some of these things. I don't keep all that information stored up here all the time. I can't keep it accessible 24/7. But anyway, why not do that? That adds a baseline point value on the damage little thingy. Like when you go into the upgrade screen and it has the little information tab on the left-hand side there. I forgot what that's called. Or did I ever know what that was called? Anyway, it's where you add all 13 damage types at a baseline point value. I'm thinking where it starts off at about 20 points of each, and you upgrade it and it goes up to 100 points of each. And that's calculated as the base value, which the other mods, such as the 6060 stat and element mods, add on to for the new total calculations. That might be technical to some people, but that's a very monosyllabic and crude way of explaining how the code in the game works. Game devs will get it. They'll snap to it and go, "Ah, I know what you're talking about." Anyway, those things I'm thinking of as steel path rewards. That way, you progressively get stronger and stronger as a player in the game. So that once you get to that point, and you go through the steel path, and you complete these certain planets, and you get these rewards from them, you'll be much better off for whatever ails you. Also, it'll give a decent incentive for people to actually want to play in the steel path. Because right now, I don't have any drive. And early on, I'm thinking, put a bunch of these in the earlier planets. Because they're what, level 100 plus, with an extra 200% of armor, shield, and health added to them, making a total of, triple. Let me explain. When you're working with adding a percentage, 100% is the same as saying times one, multiplied it by one. Same thing, it's not going to change. You add an extra 100% on top of the base, it's multiplying it by two. When you add 200%, it's multiplying it by three. It doesn't make sense until you understand mathematically. The baseline 100% is something you're adding on top of. So effectively, enemies in the steel path are at three times their normal defense and offense capabilities. But there's nothing wrong with that, except for in one of the previous five updates, DE reduced the strengths of elemental damage outputs against enemies. And I saw my 30 1,000 damage output on my Kuva Ogress drop significantly, as well as on my melee instrument, the Zaw I made. I went from 4 strikes with the Zaw on the normal steel path enemy to somewhere around 8. In most cases, it was a little more than double the amount of effort put in. For me, the steel path is just fucking tedious. So, I want a reward that makes it easier as I go along. Just like when you start in the base game. You start with whatever frame you picked. You have no mods. You have to start from scratch. That's how I'm approaching my thought process for this steel path. And,
fuck off, train!
And these additions I'm thinking of. Also, I would like to see primed versions of the 6060 mods where it gives us 120 or 200% on status and critical. There's a lot of mods in the game, but DE, I hope you see this. I would like to talk with you guys and lay everything out plainly. In regards of a lot of the baseline stuff needs to have upgrades to it. There's some common mods that don't have higher tiers of their selves. And a lot of this stuff needs some prime versions of it. And hey, maybe you can put that idea I had for, you know, once you get to a certain mastery rank. Or maybe it's that in conjunction with completing a certain place in the steel path. You make it to where Riven Disposition never drops below a certain number out of 5. And then, you know, as you go up in mastery rank, it just continuously gets stronger. To where it's consistently, well, permanently 5 out of 5 once you get to, what, mastery rank 25, 30? You know, some reward, gain for effort for higher level players, and something to aspire and to want to achieve for people just starting or who are muddling through, you know, stuff like that. Anyway, I just wanted to get these thoughts out of my head and in some form of out there for people to know and see. That way I didn't have to bother keeping those thoughts in my mind to write them out or text them out or type them out or whatever. Well, that's it. There's links in the description of my videos for whatever form of you wanting to throw fallacy credits my way that you choose. Patreon, PayPal, that sort of thing. Like or dislike, please do share. That's one thing I really want you to do is share this video. That way a lot of people can see it. We can get at least some dialogue going on. Get enough people saying, okay, well that's a neat idea. What about adding this to it? What about changing it this way? Just don't throw it out there as what you say is a change, or think that I'm throwing this out there as what I'm saying is the absolute, because it's definitely not going to be. Nothing is so permanent and unchangeable. But please do share this video. Till next time, bye.